Hey guys, this is David Kwan, and in this video I want to talk about a music album that I really just kind of grew up with. I really enjoyed it. I really respected this album. It's one of my most, in terms of the attachment that I had with it, all the songs in this album, it really is like one of my most favorite albums ever, simply because of the emotional attachment I had with this. I listened to it so many times, and the album is Rocking the Suburbs by Ben Folds. I'm not really sure if this album was actually Ben Folds 5 or Ben Folds, but it is one of his earlier ones, but also kind of his later ones, because Ben Folds is a very prolific artist. But yeah, this is the album that really got me into it, to his music. Although, it wasn't this album that made me to kind of discover him. I discovered him through a radio station, and in California, Bakersfield, California, the radio station was Kelly 98.5, I believe. That's one of the stations that plays all these hip-hop songs that are popular and trending in the early 2000s. And the song that played that really just hooked me was Still Fighting It by Ben Folds, and that just listening to that song for the first time just really grabbed me. I don't know why, because a lot of the songs in this album seems to be about fatherhood in some ways, or seems to be about kind of being a hopeless romantic, some of the songs. And there is this kind of a, I don't know, there isn't a unifying theme to it, but there are a couple of songs about that, like Annie Waits, and Jack and Sarah is an interesting one. Gone is an interesting song. And then there are songs in which it's like a story, kind of a real life story. I know not the same as a real life story, and Fred Jones Part 2, I feel like that's a fictional story, but it's very like the song that tells a story. But really, fatherhood is a big theme also in this album, and of course, Still Fighting It is about growing up. That growing up sucks and it's hard. And it's kind of like this father who's talking to his own son and just kind of telling his life lesson. And the song is really powerful, and the theme is amazing. And I love the singing voice of Ben Folds, because he's kind of has this high-pitched voice, and he can hit the high pitch really well. But at the same time, it's still melodic, and it's still a male voice. I love it. I really, really, really love this album. I listened to it so many times. I feel like I say this now, but if I ever, end up marrying someone who has kind of my sensibilities in a way, perhaps even my sense of humor or similar to it, I would like it if I can have the wedding song, if I can have our wedding song be The Luckiest. It's kind of crude in a way, but I really like that part in that song where I think it's the second verse. It talks about how there's this couple who lived to be in their 90s, and the wife lived to be about 9 years old, and then she passed away. And then or the husband, actually, the husband passed away, and then the wife, she lived for a couple more days, and then she passed away. And the song is just like, I know this is a weird way to put it, but this is just me telling you, how much I love you. I want to live and grow old with you like that. And it kind of goes back to the chorus saying that I realize now that I really am the luckiest. And the implication of that lyric there is that I'm the luckiest for having met you, for having to develop this relationship with you. I mean, to me, it's such a beautiful song. It's like one of the, I consider it as a really sweet love song, even though the lyrics, you have to really kind of do some little mental juggling here and there to get that sense, but I really love that one. Fred Jones Part 2, I think that's just the name of the song. I don't think there's a Fred Jones Part 1. It's an interesting title. Fred Jones Part 1 is probably, Part 1 is how he had his life. He grew up, he has this job. But Part 2, Fred Jones gets fired from his job or gets laid off and it's kind of the story about getting laid off, and to, like, it's a beautiful, sad song, and that's certainly an amazing thing. I don't know, this song, like, it so got to me. It's so weird, as a kid, as a junior high school student, one song that really got to me was Textbook Hippie Man, The Ascent of Stan, right? That's the name of the song, sorry, one of the choruses, Textbook Hippie Man. That's why I thought the name of the song was Textbook Hippie Man, but it's actually The Ascent of Stan. And the song begins with this, like, crazy piano, like, it's just piano riff that begins, and it crescendos, and it gets faster and faster. And at first, the first number of times I listened to the song, I was just like, the lyrics are really weird. I have no idea what the hell he's talking about. And then I realized it's talking about fatherhood. And it's, you know, as a kid, you're always rebelling against your father, against your parent. And then you become the father. And this transition is, you know, that's why, one of the lyrics in that song is like, how does it feel now that you've essentially become what you've always ran away from, or what you've always fought against? You become a father now, who you've always rebelled against. I, as a kid, just, once I figured this out, I don't know, I related so much to it, and I ended up loving the song so much, even though I'm not a father at the time, I'm a junior high school student. I don't know how I ended up relating to the song so much, but I did. I think The Ascent of Stan, at one point, this is like, this is my song in this album. This is like my ultimate favorite song. But I mean, there's so many songs in this album that is just really kick-ass. Although, there's some songs in here that I'm just like, whatever. The album is named Rocking the Suburbs, and one of the tracks in the song, one of the songs in the album is Rocking the Suburbs. I really don't care for that song. It's an upbeat song. It is kind of a parody of being white and living in the suburbs, and how hard that could be, how tough of a life that can be. It's a funny song to consider, but I don't really dig it that much, and I don't really like it that much. But, you know, a lot of the songs here I do find to be quite beautiful. The Luckiest and Fred Jones Part 2, like, that can have me in tears. Did that, like, in certain moments, like, it has me really emotional, those songs. I love the story songs. Jack and Sarah, very upbeat song. I found on YouTube that Ben Folds eventually is accompanied by the West Australia Symphony Orchestra. So he has a show in Australia, and the symphony orchestra plays alongside him, and there's a whole bunch of YouTube videos on that. Jack and Sarah, a rendition that he plays with the West Australian Symphony Orchestra. Amazing. So awesome. I love that song. I love the story of Jack and Sarah, and the Annie Waze is also, like, kind of a sad story in a way. But probably the one I find the most, you know, hilarious and just a really fun song is Not the Same. And it's actually a true story. And the lyrics are pretty literal. He took a trip, and then he climbed a tree. Well, like, you know, I watched some YouTube videos where Ben Folds explained this song, and one of his friends at Robert Stein's party, you know, because that's in the lyrics, actually, Robert's party, one of his friends goes on an acid trip. That's why he takes a trip. Climbs a tree, and he stays there for about 24 hours, and then when he comes down, he accepts Jesus Christ and becomes a Christian, and he's not the same. It's a literal story. The lyrics in that song are literally true. So that's amazing, but I love the tune of that song, and the lyrics are fun. Just really, really great album. It's really an album that I really grew up with. And it's still an album I look really fondly back to. I can listen to it still and still really enjoy it and repeat listening to some of the same songs over and over again, and it just brings me a lot of great joy. This is one of those albums I consider as like my personal classics, my personal favorites ever. So just wanted to share that with you, how much I love this album, how much I love this artist. All right? Cheers.